We'll be starting the workout on your seat with shoulder presses. Keep your core tight and try to keep your upper body from moving. Coming up, we have alternating leg kickbacks. Use your seat as support and raise your leg one at a time while pointing the bottom of your foot towards the ceiling. You can either hold the weight or just use body weight, but we'll be doing step-ups next. Make sure the object you're stepping on is sturdy before you move on. Going back to the seated press next, pick a good pace for this interval. A minute is a very long time to be doing shoulder presses, so you want to pick a pace you can maintain. Leg kickbacks coming up. You want your leg to be the only thing really moving, and you should feel your glute and hamstrings activate on the way up. Step ups up next. You want to drive out of your heel on each step up and keep your upper body from leaning forward during this move. Round 3 beginning with seated press. Keep an eye on your form to make sure you're not leaning forward or back when you do each press. You can correct this by keeping your core tight. Leg kickbacks next. You can use your hands as a stable base when doing each movement and press out through your palms for a little extra support as you raise your legs back. Step ups coming up. If you're using weight, you ideally want them as still as possible. You don't want momentum to play any factor during this move. We're entering the last round. Awesome work, team. Seated press next. This last minute is going to burn real good, but hang in there. Let's make it count. Leg kickbacks coming up. Let's make that mind-body connection and think about activating your glutes at the top of each rep. Closing out the workout with step-ups. Your legs might be burning, so just keep a close eye on where you're taking each step. Safety first. Thanks for joining me on that conditioning piece. Subscribe to the bbaliFit channel to join me for more great workouts. I'll see you guys for the next one.